Me? I'm very successful.
Whoa. That just said, started. Far from home. Did we get the newest deal here? Listen to the Valentine Agency radio? Is there a new channel?
This is Ellie Perkins from Valentine's Detective Agency with a message for Nick's partner. We've got a new case and it sounds urgent. Stop by the office. I'll be waiting. Setting this to repeat. This is Ellie Perkins from Valentine's Detective Agency with a message for Nick's partner. We've got a new case and it sounds urgent. Stop by the office. I'll be waiting. Setting this to repeat.
Okay. Do we want to jump on that? Because, I mean, I'm in the middle of something. And although they say it's urgent, you should do it right now. You don't necessarily have to do it right now, usually, with Fallout. But on the other hand, it could be incredibly cool.
A few inches later.
I hope nothing's wrong.
Wrong? No, not at all. I've been waiting for the right moment to talk to you, and I suppose this is as good a time as any. After helping me get Duncan's cure from MedTech, I figured I owe you something. And I always pay my debts. Here. I wanted you to have this. I know a carved toy soldier is a strange reward for risking your life, but this one's special. It means a lot to me.
Did you make this yourself?
Do I look like the artistic type to you? My wife Lucy gave this to me right after we met. I told her I was a soldier and she made it for me. Never could bring myself to tell her the truth. I was just a hired killer. The soldier story was the best thing I could come up with. I didn't want to lose her because of what I was.
I'm sure you had good intentions.
I had a feeling you'd get where I was coming from. It doesn't really matter anymore. She died a few years back. We made the mistake of holing up in a metro station one night. We didn't know that the place was infested with ferals. They were on her before I could even fire a shot. Ripped her apart right in front of me. There was nothing I could do. Took everything I had to escape with Duncan in my arms. Maybe it would have been better if he died there with her.
You may have lost your wife, but you saved your son. That counts for something.
Maybe. I don't know anymore. Damn, I miss Lucy. No matter how bad things got, she was always there with a shoulder to lean on. It gave me the courage I needed to press ahead. To never give up. When she died, I thought that feeling was gone forever. Then I met you. You have the world's problems in your back, and here you are helping me with mine. Lending me your shoulder like Lucy did. I just want you to know how much your friendship means to me.
Hey, man. Only best friends can share feelings like that with each other.
And I aim to keep it that way. Anyway, thanks for hearing me out. Taking all that weight off my shoulders makes the journey a little easier, if you know what I mean. Speaking of which, it's about time we got back on the road, don't you think?
Nothing new to report. Keep it tuned here for Minutemen Alerts.
I wonder how long I've been waiting for this to come up when I really could have just talked to him. That's different. I feel like I'm going to be leaving him at Spectacle Island. And it's backwards. Still, well, it's here. We'll put it in a better spot. There you go. No, it's not backwards. Oh, good. That's just about perfect. Very nice. Okay, let's talk about prep.
Got a dangerous look about you.
That I do.
Okay, here for me.
First of all,
not to mess with you when you're in that thing.
Okay, here's the dealio. Gotten a bunch more ammo. Picked up on my fusion cores. Yeah, I have a couple of mods I can get rid of here. No junk. Apparel-wise, the only thing I'm taking with me here is a hazmat suit because of where we're headed. Bring in the big boy. Of course, the explosive combat shotgun. I powered up a high speed. You know, I forgot I didn't get rank 4 of gun nuts, so I couldn't make it a perfect minigun. But you know, you want at least one minigun. If you have 3,000 rounds of ammunition, you might as well bring it. Furious Power Fist, which I can't use in the power armor, but it's a nice weapon. And if I'm, you know, hopping around in a hazmat suit, trying to get low on ammo for some reason, and you know, if you just have a situation where you want to punch somebody out, that's a good thing. Bringing the never-ending hardened piercing 10mm, because it's got 3,000 rounds of ammunition and it just shoots forever. Cryolator, of course. Syringe rifle, I haven't even used it once, but you never know. And right now, of course, I'm using the two-shot boosted fire, because although it's not quite as good, I don't think, because of the area effect with the blast on the explosive, I think this is definitely better. Because of the all the 15 bullets per pellet. This one, I've got a lot more ammo. And with the double shot, you know, if you especially zoomed in, now you're doing 280. So it's fire damage. It's not bad. It's a good rifle. In my best power suit, it's loaded with its modified T60. And now I think we're just about ready. Let's get rid of those couple of mods just for weight. And my miss, my mods, bing bing. Let's go see. I thought I left our buddy here. It's possible he's at the slog. What I really think is that when I got the radio signal, so did Nick. So therefore, he's probably already at his office to kick this whole Far Harbor thing off. We're looking at a lamp. Look at how pretty it is, even though it's beat to heck and rusty. It's still a nice lamp. It's spinning and loading, and let's see. Again, just making sure.
Yes?
I hope you realize how much you did for us.
Yeah. Is that Nick?
You'd help us.
It is Nick.
Let me know if how are we doing on the hunt for Eddie's tapes?
Still searching.
Still searching for them.
Just let me know when you manage to get.
You got other problems, Nick.
Hey, Valentine.
Time to hit the road again? Get back to the hunt for Eddie Winter?
Let's head out.
Well, all right.
Damn, I forgot to pick up that motor oil for you, Valentine.
Cute, MacCready. You come up with that all on your own?
Send MacCready to Spectacle Island. Confirm the travel.
Yes.
All right. Ooh, you know what? We really should fix that arm. Let's see. Where do I have?
Looks like we can catch a breather in here.
Huh? Yeah, we ain't catching no breathers. We'll go to home plate. Because Homeplate does have an armor. But Homeplate doesn't have anything to make to fix armor with. We have to go someplace different. What else is there? Your Hogden's close enough. I'll need access to all of my steel and whatever else this thing needs. I'll fix up the arm. Whatever else needs to be fixed up. You know, you're going out here. I don't know. See, now this is the interesting thing. I don't know. Is this going to be one of those add-ons where you can go back and forth between the two areas easily? Or is it going to be like, once you go there, you're there till you beat it, and then you can come back and forth? Or maybe once you leave it, it's gone forever? I mean, there's different options here that we don't know. We just don't know.
Functions are
Okay, let's do through the repair here. Repair the torso, repair the leg, repair the right leg, repair the arm. Oh, good, the arm's good. The helmet needs... Everything needed a little something. Get out of my way. I wonder, is there any other mods I can put on this thing? That's that. Is that the max model? Yeah, prism shielding, that's what we want. Model E. Yeah, I think we're good. Look at this! This is...
I assume your silence means you're in deep thought. Take your time.
No, it means I'm surrounded by a cow and a robot, and I just want to get in my armor and get out of my way. Let's do this thing. Can you sleep in armor? I wonder if that'd be funny. No, not really, particularly. Can't do that while in power armor, fine. Screw it. We don't need that much. I'm sure there'll be a place to sleep when we get there. Or, better yet, if you go to home plate now. Go to home plate. No one's gonna steal the armor from home plate. I don't have to bother with pulling the core on it. You go over here. What time is it? Yeah, let's sleep for a nice long sleep. I've been running back and forth across the entire Commonwealth. You know, it's in truth, I probably would sleep 14 hours at that point. What would you dream about? So I've got the well-rested perk. I'm armoring up. Clickety-clack. The RoboBrain, constructed by General Atomics International before the Great War, when most stuff was constructed, is unique in that it uses an actual organic brain as its central processor that has held up for 200 years. That must be some good jello they put in there with it. And it's not getting a lot of nutrients otherwise. Which way are we going? We're going this way?
You know what you're looking for? We have everything!
Yeah.
Need new clothes? Should stop by Fallon's baseball. Open during the day.
Don't remember which way is to Valentine's place.
You've been to Good Neighbor? Friggin' ball. Move the cameras.
That's pretty true. All right, Yang, are you ready? Are you ready to look at what Far Harbor brings to us?
I'm glad you're here. We got a new case while you and Nick were out. Ready to put on the detective hat?
Tell me more.
Our client is a fisherman who lives on the edge of the Commonwealth. Kenji Nakano.
Nakano? That name takes me back. My memory's a little fuzzy on the details, though.
Maybe if you bothered writing things down, Nick.
Can't do that. Wouldn't want to put you out of a job.
I'll remember that the next time you need me to console a hysterical client. Mr. Nakano didn't leave many details. Said he'd go over everything when you meet him. But if you want my guess, missing person case. Guy had a worried look a mile long.
Should we try sarcastic, just for the heck of it?
So, is the fedora and trench coat mandatory when solving these cases? Because I'm thinking smoking pipe and British accent.
Hey, whatever floats your boat, gumshoe. The Nakano residence is up in the northeast, near the coast. A small fishing house. He said that he and his wife will be waiting for you.
It's a long walk. That's how the hard cases always start.
So, a long walk. Where are we walking? Wow. Looks like, I mean, anything here, this is going to get shot at. The lighthouse, though. This is stuff, you know, have to walk past some stuff. We're going to have to shoot some things here, aren't we? Yeah, I don't think that's on my map yet. Well, some stuff's going to be on my map. We have to go up through here. At least we have the lighthouse. At least we've got MacCready's perk, so we don't have to steal any more bad meat. Which makes me bring up an interesting point. I've decided, just because this is going to be a hot topic, that I'm going outside the normal realm of the regularly scheduled podcast here, YouTube cast here. So there's a lot more that you get to see later on about potted meat and MacCready and all the stuff that went on here. But in due time. Now, let's get to this. Sometimes you gotta make these decisions. Like, you know, right now, this is gonna be the hot topic. What's gonna go on with... Is this worth buying? Is it worth getting? Is it, you know... What's it like? So we're going to try and push this to market here a little bit. We're going to try and get these videos out as quick as we can knock them out. Just like we did with the other two DLCs, really. And once they got integrated with the main storyline. Crater House is over there. You don't want to go near that. It's full of Children of the Atom. Guns. And a vaporized bug. Okay.
Hey, toss anything you can't haul my way.
You know, that's not a bad plan. Nick.
Hey.
Now, see what I can do. Whatever you need.
Probably just a good idea to give him stuff like the big boy. I'll keep the minigun. The cryolate. Eh, can you carry the syringer rifle? Yeah, that's a... There you go. That just saves me a little weight. There's always a chance he'll just start whipping out a nuke, but I mean, yeah. This is an interesting little shack. Yeah, that's good junkaroonies. I really should just touch base here and get names on those things, but I don't want to distract us too much from what's going on. You can always get the locations later. Whee! Almost stepped on a bird. It's raining, but I've got my power armor, and Nick over here uses mind over matter. He don't mind, so it don't matter. This looks like it's a potential... let's take the high ground here a little bit. Anything going on? Does anything light up? In the targeting scope? Well! This is an unfortunate picnic. I was just having a picnic, didn't have the radio on. Poof! Direction. Keep going in the right direction. What the heck was... okay. It's... Michler meat. Who doesn't like a little Michler meat? It makes sense as we're heading out to try to find this boat. Oh dear. Okay, now we're gonna need. I know what you're thinking. You're thinking, oh, you need the nuclear thing. Nope. Ready? Is you ready? And that's why I like this shotgun. We are going to go on our trip here with some junk, some stuff that's not really pertinent. Anything else up ahead? This has a shorter scope on it. Are they happy people? Might be our contacts. We'll try not to accidentally shoot them. But yeah, let's leave the explosive gun out for a little while. I wonder what this is. Nah, this is curious. This got me curious. They're not hostile. Yeah, they are! Why didn't they show up in the scope? That should have targeted them. And now, of course, part of the traditions of the, wasteland, we gotta leave these guys naked. Alright. Now we're overloaded, you know. Okay, let's do this. Is that? That's something going on.
Head over to the Nakano residence when we can. Find out what their case is about.
Yeah, well, yeah, you know, maybe we have to really think here about, is any of this stuff good? You put it in this truck? Harness. It's not like I don't have 700 of them. And almost 100,000 caps. And you can't get too... crazy on this stuff here. Yeah, there you go. Remember it's in the pink truck at the end of the... You should really head over to the Nakano residence. Yeah, I got that. It is a nice long walk. Now it's pouring rain. How we doing? Where are we at here, map-wise? We're almost there. Is that it? I mean, are they in that? No, it's up this way, up the sheer cliff face. Are you kidding me? You know they knew this was gonna happen. At least I can climb a sheer cliff face. Someone shooting? Gee, the Nakano's, live in, like, a building? Or is it, like... We should be able to see it by now. There you go. Thumpity, thumpity, thumpity. Thumpy, thumpy, thumpy! Well, this is actually pretty elaborate. And another sheer cliff face. no concern to me because I'm in power armor. This is pretty elaborate.
Damn it! Come in! I know you're listening on the other end. Where is she? Where is my daughter?
Kenji, please. You've been at this for hours. Stop. You need sleep.
She's out there, Ray. Someone has her. Ray.
I hope you don't mind. We let ourselves in.
Nick, thank God.
Please, he's down.
Work right away. She could be hurt. She could be...
Whoa, slow down. Kenji, was it? Why did you go over the details with me and my partner here?
You brought a partner? Good. The more eyes, the better.
Okay, let's do a save.
So, what's the story with you and Nick?
Nick didn't tell you? Ran with him on one of his cases a few years back, searching for some sort of lost heirloom. He needed a boat. Things didn't end well. We were double-crossed by the client once we had what he was looking for. I still have some lead lodged into my hip.
Right. Yeah, it's starting to come back to me. Sorry things ended sour.
We got out. That's all that mattered. And now you can return the favor by finding my daughter.
We're here to help. Tell us what happened.
It's all thanks to this damn radio.
Our daughter Kasumi likes to fix things. The radio was her latest project.
Until she made contact with some kidnapper who lured her away from us.
Or maybe she left on her own. She's not a child anymore. Our daughter is 19. She knows how to survive, and she's capable. I think maybe she left because she wanted her own life.
No. She would have told us where she was going. She would have said something. I know my daughter is in danger. I can feel it. Find her, please.
Yeah, I'm not gonna ask for her. I don't need cash.
Do you have any idea where she could have gone?
We know she took one of the boats, but that's all. She could be anywhere.
We'll find her. Don't you worry.
Thank you. Her room is upstairs, if that helps. And if you had any more questions about her, just ask.
Don't worry, Kenji. We'll get to the bottom of this. Just sit tight.
Okay, optional. I'll question them further. Let's do that. And just to get around a little easier. And just so they don't... so he doesn't glitch. Well, you know what? Let's find out if that's a possibility. If they can steal it on me.
Mrs. Nakano.
I suppose you have questions about my daughter.
Tell me more about this radio your daughter was working on.
I remember Kasumi was very excited about it. I figured she was secretly trying to make contact with Diamond City or another settlement. We're pretty isolated out here. She only has us for company, and Kenji can be overprotective.
You and your husband don't seem to agree about why your daughter left.
We both want to find her. The world out there isn't a place where you want to be alone. But Kenji still sees her swaddled in diapers. He doesn't see a young woman with her own decisions to make. Maybe because it's more frightening. She wasn't tricked into leaving without telling us. That was her choice. She didn't want us to follow. Why?
I'd like to know more about Kasumi. Might shine a light on where she's gone.
My daughter is strong, focused, careful. That's how I know she's still alive. But why would she leave without telling us? Maybe we... No, never mind. I don't want to waste your time.
Okay, let's click save. We may have to try this a few times.
Every detail is important, Mrs. Nakano. Don't hold back.
It's just that we've been fighting a lot more. All of us. Ever since Kasumi's grandfather passed away, he was the only one that could really talk to her. Kenji and I don't understand machines, but those two could work together for hours. She started staying in her grandfather's boathouse late into the night. I thought she was just trying to cope with the loss, but now I wonder what she was up to.
Okay, so we got that.
Nothing else right now.
Can we still talk to him? I got the option.
Did you have questions about my daughter?
Tell me more about this radio she was fixing.
I've tried to get that damn thing to work over and over again, but there's nothing. I thought she just wanted to strip it for parts or build a toaster out of it or something, like she usually does. Someone made contact with her, and then they took her. God, what kind of twisted psychopath has my daughter?
Anything more you can tell me about Kasumi? The smallest detail could be important.
I don't know what more to say. She's my little girl, and she doesn't know how dangerous this world is. I never should have let her grandfather teach her how to fix these machines.
Her grandfather? He taught her how to fix the radio?
Ever since she was old enough to walk, yes. Her grandfather had an ear for machines. Kasumi picked up the knack. He passed away recently. He used to scavenge the ruins in the south for parts. I kept telling him he was getting too old.
Why did your daughter really leave? Your wife says she left on her own, but you said it was kidnappers.
I know it was kidnappers. Kasumi is a smart girl, but she doesn't know how horrible people can be. Not like me and Rei. Why would she just leave her family with no explanation? Someone tricked her. Got her to leave the safety of home. Every minute we aren't looking for my daughter, her life is in jeopardy.
No more questions right now.
Work quickly, Detective.
Okay. Let's see here now. Where is... Well, I guess this is her room. She likes cats. We know that. Try rocket chips, stuff here. Combo wrench. Doesn't look like a combo wrench. Does it look like a combo wrench to you? That looks like some kind of... No, it's definitely not a combo wrench. Oh, there's the combo wrench. What's this thing? It's just be just a... You can barely see the combo wrench next to that green thingy. Try rocket chip.
We're sucking down a lot of rats sticking around here.
Where's the... Her bed's radioactive? Or is there a rad storm going on? Screwdrivers. Yeah, great, we got a rad. Oh, wait a minute! Kasumi's project. Let's see. Inventory. Miscellaneous. Kasumi. Slappity, slick, slack.
Project log? Radio. Correction, working radio. I'll finally get some news outside this house. My handle is going to be... Let's go with... Ohm's Law. That should confuse the creeps. And if someone actually gets the reference, then we'll at least have circuitry in common.
Okay, so she's a turbo nerd. That's a good thing. Nothing like trying to... What's this? Kasumi's Project's lamp.
Project log. Lamp. Yep. It's a lamp. Filament plus power equals light. I swear, sometimes I think my parents break these things just to keep me busy.
But, you know, let's wait out the rats. For 2 hours. Yeah. Won't let me wait. No, because of the rats, probably. Although, that never happened before. That's... Think there's anything else going on here? Well, we should probably, at the bare minimum, get back in our suits. We're not stuck in... Wait a minute, what am I doing? Silliness. Nope. didn't really give me any of everything here. I can walk around all day in it now. Less than one rads. Let's see. Let's look at this here boathouse. There's the boat. The boat looks like that could be a deal here. There's a cat. The cat could be important. First time using the hazmat suit, supposedly it really cuts it down to nothing. We got dead computer. Battery clipboard. Small baby bottle. Grandfather's note. My dear Kasumi, if you ever get locked out of the safe, then the answer is here in the boathouse. Picture where the key is. Love, Granddad. Picture where the key is. So the key is where the picture is. There's a picture. There you go. Examine. You found a key hidden within the frame.
Now, let's see what's in that safe.
That's the plan. Well, military grade duct tape. Sorry, I'm taking your military grade duct tape. That's. Listen to Kasumi's final tape.
Project log? Myself. I never really thought about who or what I am, but God, where do I start? The radio. I was right about the range. I managed to get a signal, a strong signal, from up north. There's a group of people up there. They say they're all synths, synthetic people, made by the Institute. They're trying to build a place for their kind, where they can be themselves and be accepted for what they are alongside human beings. It sounds wonderful, but then they started asking about me, and some questions came up. Questions I don't have answers to. I mean, I've always felt off, like I'm not really supposed to be here, but then there are things in my childhood I can't remember, and I've been having strange dreams. I'm going to go to meet these synths. I have to know the truth about myself. They've told me to sail up north to a town called Bar Harbor. I can make my way to them from there.
Okay, well, this makes some sense, of course.
The daughter takes off 5 boats, but more importantly, there's a colony of synths up near this Bar Harbor. We need a way to get there. Let's go talk to Kenji. He knows the waters better than anyone.
He's a complete wackadoodle, though. Ah, the rad storm's over. That's good. Well, let's go back to, all the other... Actually, I could just go with the Silver Shroud for right now. That's right, you've got the Silver Shroud on your case. Meow. Are there shroud options? You can try it.
Have you finished your investigation? Did you find anything?
Should we ask her if she's... That's just gonna get me slapped. Let's save just in case this is like a...
I need to ask you an important question. Are you sure your daughter is human?
What kind of question is that? Why are you asking?
Your daughter made contact with a group of synths. She thinks she's one of them.
What? That's crazy.
She's not a synth. She's our daughter. We raised her. I gave birth to her. She's flesh and blood, not a synthetic.
Let's not suggest that. Let's see, are you sure?
Were you going to say something?
Are you sure she's human, Mrs. Nakano?
Yes, I know my daughter and she hasn't changed. She's not some replacement.
This is what I was afraid of. Someone twisting my daughter's mind. Did you find where Kasumi went, Detective?
I think I know where Kasumi went. A place called Far Harbor.
She went that far up north? God, that explains why she took the boat. You have to go after her. Please, take my other ship on the dock outside. My father's design. It has a guidance system, and it is built for distance.
What can I expect out there, Kenji?
I only made the trip to Far Harbor once, when I was a boy. All I remember is that my father did not want to stay long. Something about the air being bad.
I'll get to the bottom of this, Kenji.
Thank you. I know you haven't asked for a payment, and we can't offer much. But here, please take it. I insist. For expenses, if nothing else.
I know it'll be hard waiting for word, but try to carry on like normal. We'll be back as soon as we can.
Fine, cousin. Please.
Let's just hop in the suit, because it doesn't really matter what I'm wearing if I'm wearing the suit. Clickety-clackety.
Don't let all that horsepower go to your head.
Okay, so we got our own boat.
The detective's life isn't an easy one, but it rarely lacks for excitement.
Leave the Commonwealth? Travel to Far Harbor! Oh, check it out! It is an automatic steering system that the guy built. So you don't have to have you don't have to know how to drive a boat. That's kind of fascinating. Of course, you also can't drive it anywhere else. I expected a black loading screen. Oh, there it is. Yeah, that's... And I figured maybe they're going to drive us all the way there. The town of Far Harbor is built entirely on a coastal pier on the edge of the island. It might not be a bad idea, at least initially, to leave the armor on the boat and go hazmat. If the air is bad. Aha! You can't exit your armor here, okay. You can leave it next to the boat. This is a happy place. Put the damn gun down, because you're going to get blasted to smithereens if I have to blast you to smithereens.
Are you lost? This is Far Harbor. We don't get many visitors around here.
We don't need no freeloaders or more help, Mainlander. So you can get back in your boat and leave.
Alan, This isn't your dock. It belongs to the whole town. And that means strangers are welcome. Sorry, you've caught us during a difficult time. But Alan's got a point. Not all visitors have good intentions. So, what's your business here?
A young woman from the Commonwealth named Kasumi may have passed through here. Her family hired me to find her.
Some sort of detective, huh? Well, she came through here all right.
At least we know she made it this far.
That's all that is?
Damn it. Mariner's incoming.
Something's coming through the fog!
You, help us defend the town, and I'll answer any questions you have. Take a post at the top of the wall near the main gate. The hall never lets us down. Now follow me!
Follow you? Where are you going?
Don't fall off! If you do, we might not be able to rescue you in time.
Okay. Shotgun up. Okay, what
you
we got?
You sure you saw something?
This ain't a drill!
That doesn't sound good.
Eyes peeled, everyone!
It's hard to see.
Open the gate! I've got wounded out here!
Mariner, there's no time. Look to the fog. They're coming.
Go first! Move on! Defend yourselves!
Radio!
Got company.
Look out! Love this gun.
It's over.
No. Eyes on the fog. Something's coming.
Reload. Are they throwing grenades at themselves?
We're clear. All right. Well done, all. Open the gate.
Need to go check that legendary.
What are you looking at?
A jerk.
Avery.
Now you see what we're up against. The fog and the creatures it spits out have taken the whole island from my people. For your help when we needed it, you deserve this.
Ooh, money.
What's the fog?
Where to begin? The fog's radioactive, right? But there are pockets of it, the deep fog, that are hard fallout. And as deadly as that is, that's only part of the problem. Things live in the fog, thrive. You think what attacked the harbor's bad? Oh, there's far worse further inland.
If you managed to survive despite all that, it must be tough.
Ornery, more like.
I'm done cowering behind your damn hull, Avery. Time you let me deal with the real problem. With the right people and my guns, I can end those Children of Adam cultists for good.
The fog's been here forever. The children didn't make it.
Before the Rat Eaters came, the fog was under control. They come, and it all goes wrong. It's time we do something.
No need to burden a stranger with all this nonsense.
What's the deal with the Children of Adam?
They're religious folk. Worship the power of Adam. Which is radiation, I guess. If you want details, you'd have to find and ask them. We used to have a peace with them until a certain hothead menace named Alan Lee.
Now that's enough. That preacher came into the harbor saying that it was Adam's will that we lost our land. That it was Adam's goddamn will that we lost so many friends and family. And that the Adam would wipe this whole place clean of us.
If it were up to me, you'd hang for what you did to that preacher, Alan. Alan pulled a gun on him. He claims the preacher reached for his. We don't have police, or really any law. Just custom and popular sentiment. And after everything the Preacher said, it was abundantly clear doing anything to Alan would have made matters worse.
Have the children made the fog worse?
Absolutely not. There's not one bit of evidence.
Geiger counters don't lie, Avery. Fog's gotten more lethal year over year. And now the fog's covering the whole island. Only after the children came.
You know as well as I do, that's happened before. Sure, people have theories the children are involved, but no one, and I mean no one, has proof.
Can we get back to business?
Sorry for all that. You're here for Kasumi, right? She headed inland to the Synth Refuge, Acadia. Getting there will be dangerous. You'll need a guide. Old Longfellow. No one knows the fog like him. But word of warning, he's a bit of an acquired taste.
What's old Longfellow's story?
He's the best hunter on the island. Fearless. Some say crazy. If someone needs to get to Acadia, he's the only one that'll do it. But people around here are known for being stubborn, willful, and other less flattering things. But Longfellow's got a reputation even among us.
What can you tell me about Acadia?
Ask Longfellow. He's the only one that's been there.
Thanks for the info.
Best place to look for Longfellow's at the bar. The last plank. And, please, lend a hand around town if you're able. Even if it's slapped away. People like the Mariner and Cassie and others need help. And let me say something you might not hear again. Thank you.
Great shop's got everything you need.
Protect your loved ones with my fine hand cannons.
Well, you know what I think. Ooh, started living on the edge. Optional help the Mariner. Optional help Cassie. Oh, that's the cat. Those two are actually part of the quest. They're not their own side quests. Let's see, what are we supposed to go through here? I think.
Whatever.
You ain't armed. You ain't long for this world. Buy my guns
now. Ah, we got all kinds of traders going on here, and this is gloomy. Well, I think this is a good place to take a break, ladies and gentlemen. See you for the next one. This is the Black Knight. Have a gloomy, creepy night.
Food. Stim packs.